Gospel, because this is a mission. It's not a happy social club. No, this is a mission to save souls. So this is important. It's not, I'm going to leave here when I have lunch afterwards and we'll check off this week and satisfy this obligation on my schedule. No, this is big. So now we get to next week when we come back and Paul really lays it on the line for us. And he says, you're working with really annoying people sometimes. And you got this fresh reminder to be like Jesus. And I have to tell you, annoying people are annoying. Anybody know any? Yeah. So, take a picture like that up on your mirror each and every day. And remember, your purpose, your goal for unity is to be like Jesus. Let's stand and pray. Wow, Father, we thank you so much that you've done so much for us. But in our ease and in our comfort, let us not rest on our laurels. We just pray, Father, that we are unified. That as Paul laid out in this great passage, you have given us a mission on earth. And we are supposed to be fulfilling that. I pray, Father, that we do. Father, this congregation desperately needs elders. We need good, godly men to step up and assume the reins and lay aside their preferences so that your kingdom might be perpetuated. So I pray for those men that you're working on, that while, Father, you work on them in big ways. Father, we need godly women who just live the image of Christ. And I pray for those women who are here without their spouse, either through loss or worship, that they're not equally yoked. I pray that their character and looking like Christ is so transformational that for those who have husbands who are not believers, that they might be won over by the good character of their wives. Father, I pray for those who are outside our doors that do not know Christ. May we be the church that invites people. May we be the church that goes out to the hedgerows and brings people in. May we be the church that truly is loving, but Father, people don't discover it because they happen to see it on a GPS map. Rather, they discover it because people are out doing the good work. They're evangelists and inviting and preaching and living the gospel in their everyday lives. So, Father, we pray for Cumberland County. We want it for you. We want this congregation to be the salt of the earth, to be a light on the hill. And we just pray, Father, that you just equip us to do your good work. In Jesus' name, amen. You're